Diao Chan's forces fought off Cao Cao's attack and readied their troops at the fortress of Hanzhong. But with the way events had transpired, first fleeing Luo Yang for Xiaping, and from there to Hanzhong, Diao Chan dared not hope to achieve her goal of returning peace to the imperial court. Meanwhile, Cao Cao swept across the land using the prestige of the imperial court as a shield. When she learned of this, Diao Chan knew Cao Cao to be a traitor who was just using the emperor and made up her mind to stop him. She and her forces signaled the launch of a counterattack from Fawn Castle.
If Dong Zhuo and Cao Cao have anything in common, it's ambition. They both were using the glory of the Imperial Han. I wish there was a way we could return the Han to its former power and glory.
Only by fighting can we achieve it. Listen. Dong Zhuo was defeated by Guile. In this battle, I will use my might to win. This will be my fight. I shall not lose. Let us go.
Did he just... say... by Guile? It can't be. He couldn't have known what I was doing. Why did he say that then?
Thank you.
Is open! Now attack!
Yeah! nothing that can be done. Gather our forces at the front gate. Attack the enemy from both sides.
So, you are next. I'll crush you.
We shall go forward. Come with me if you are able. I have come for your head.
See, I'm more than just a pretty face.
I honor your skill. Now, let us show ours as well.
End your scourge. Face me.
Well done. You have a positive effect on our forces. It is time to unveil my plan. Begin the advance.
Yeah. Face me if you dare.
Wait here to regroup with the others.
The fate of my troops lies in my hand. I cannot fail.
Cannot have happened to me.
See, I'm more than just a pretty face.
We have beaten Zhao Ren. Now, on to Bang Castle. Let's go, Diao Chan. Next, we face Cao Cao.